Good evening. It's Saturday, the 14th of June, 1997. At a celebration party in London this evening, BBC News says goodbye to 40 of its longest-serving editors. Spanning a collective total of 850 years, people from all sections of the media gathered to pay their respects to their friends and colleagues. We can now go live to the London Regalia, where our party correspondent, Pete Millest, will bring us up to date.
Well, it's Saturday the 14th of June, 1997, and we're here at the London Regalia floating barge in the East End of London to say goodbye to 40 members of the picture editing department. And we're hopefully tonight going to have a wonderful time and say goodbye to lots of colleagues and friends that we love and admire. Glenda and I go back a long way.
We do.
And I'm just ever so glad you're here. And don't worry, we won't throw you overboard tonight.
Oh,
I'm so pleased because you'll love the special guest. You really will.
No, who is it?
Oh,
London also celebrated the Queen's birthday at the annual Trooping the Colour ceremony. And later, there was a royal guest of honour at the London Regalia celebrations, where she was regrettably molested. Proceedings were called to a halt when three young studs kidnapped a lady-in-waiting. She was sadly disappointed. We now go live to the celebrations.
It's rather a shame about this weather, isn't it? Yes. Would you put the tone to stand, please?
Would you please stand, Your Majesty?
Your Majesty. Your Majesty.
Her Majesty and Patsy darling, are here tonight to pay homage to some very dear colleagues who are here. People who are very dear to me personally, and I'm sure dear to everybody who's here tonight. So I would now like to pass over the microphone to Mum.
We would like you all to thank me for being here this evening. To bid a fond au revoir to some of my loyal subjects. Forever young Crombie.
Tad, Mum.
Oh. So it's not my fault. Tony Tompers. Thompson.
Yes, he's rather dishy, isn't he?
Step forward, Mr. and Mrs. Smith. Ian, dear boy Johnson. Welcome, Mike Bricky Davies, and a connoisseur of opera and aromatherapy. Marion Matron Green. Howard, Mr. Chair Davis. I'm not on world again, am I, Ellis? Welcome, Vince VT12 Fitzgerald. Mr. Fitzgerald, Jane Happy Harrison. Welcome, Maggie. It's good to talk Reynolds. Welcome to Derek, forever young Wisby.
Would you like to read it with me, Mr.
No, you just read it.
Peter Black Leather Townsend.
A great pleasure for all of us to have celebrated this event on board the Marie Millest. which is just about what the fourth floor will be like after this occasion. Had this boat sunk, though, as someone who has been a worker down on the fourth floor with all these people for over many years, in my view, it would have been the greatest loss of talent since the Titanic went down many years ago.
It is invidious always to single out a few because so many have put so much into it. But we must mention Mr. Millest, who is sitting there, pretending to be shy. And particularly Mary Ferguson, Fergie, a wonderful lady, Queen of Scots. I don't know what Queen of Peter is, but anyway. And I have been asked to present, my God, we have been asked to present Fergie with a small token of our appreciation for her hard work and for being a wonderful lady.
Celebrations are expected to continue well into the night as we bid a fond farewell to our friends and colleagues and thank them for their loyal and distinguished service to BBC News. Cheers.
End of the Second World War in